Hello everyone. Today's lecture will be continuation of objective applications of the colligative properties. So today again we are going to discuss some more typical examples in which the colligative properties should all be used. So without wasting our time, let's begin with this first question. So the question says, 1 molar solution of a carboxylic acid in benzene produces an elevation in boiling point of 1.518 Kelvin. What is the degree of dimerization of acid in benzene if Kb of benzene is given? So now look at this. Question revolves around delta Tb. So therefore look at this. Delta Tb, elevation and boiling point, is equals to I times Kb into molarity. So delta Tb, Kb, m is given. So what we have to find is the van der Waal, van of factor I. So I is equals to delta Tb by Kb m. So delta Tb is 1.518 K, Kb is 2.53, molarity is 1. So this is I, van 't Hoff factor. Now question for this says, what is the degree of dimerization of acids? Now question says dimerization of acid. We have this organic acid RCOOH. 2 moles reach to give you dimer. So therefore look at this. For this, since 2 moles is undergoing dimerization, N is equals to 2. Now we have relationship between degree of association and I. So degree of association alpha is equals to I minus 1, 1 by n minus 1. So this can also be written as 1 minus I divided by 1 minus 1 by n. So we have this I. So 1.518 divided by 2.53. So 1.518 divided by 1 minus 1.518 divided by 2.53, that is 1 minus I divided by 1 minus 1 by n. N is equals to 2, see this is 2. So therefore alpha is equals to 2.53 minus 1.518 divided by 2.53. So 1 minus half is half. So this is multiplied by 2. So this is the value of alpha, degree of dissociation. So 2.53 minus 1.58. into 2 divided by 2.53, so this is 2.024 divided by 2.53. So let's see. This is 8 3 the 24, 8 5 the 40, 42, 8 to the 16, 20. So this is 0.8, or this can be written as 80%. So now look at this. So first, from this given data, we find out this van 't Hoff factor I. Now we write the equation, that is dimerization of acid in benzene. So N equals to 2, that means 2 moles of acid combines to give you 1 mole of dimer. And we have this relationship alpha, there is degree of association and Van Hoff factor I. So this is the first problem in which we have to find out degree of association from elevation boiling point. Second question says, the freezing point of a 4% aqueous solution of A is equals to the freezing point of 10% aqueous solution of B. If the molar mass of A is 60, then what is the molar mass of B? So, freezing point of 4% aqueous solution of A equals to freezing point of 10% aqueous solution of B. Molar mass of A is given, then what is the molar mass of B? Now look at this. Concentration of the solution is given as 4% and 10%. So therefore look at this. Delta TB of A, F of A is equal to delta TF of B. This is clearly given in question. So delta TF, that is KF into molality of A is equals to KF molality of B. This cancels out. So therefore look at this, molality of A, number of moles of A divided by mass of solvent in kilogram. Is equals to number of moles of B into 1000 divided by mass of water, because this is aqueous solution, in gram. Again look at this, this cancels out. So therefore look at this, number of moles of A, mass of A divided by molar mass of A into mass of water is equals to mass of B divided by molar mass of B into mass of water. So mass of A is given as 4%, that means out of 100 gram, 4 gram of A is present, divided by molar mass of A is given as 60, 96 gram. So mass of B, that means out of 100 gram, 10 gram is B. So we have 10 gram of B. We have to find the molar mass of B. Mass of water is 90 gram. So therefore, molar mass of B is equals to 10 into 60 into 96 divided by 4 into 90. So this is the molar mass of B. So this is 160 gram per mole. So condition, look at this, question says freezing point of 4% solution is equal to freezing point of 10%, that means depression and freezing point of A, that is 4%, equals to depression and freezing point of B, that is 10% solution. So 4% means 4 gram in 100 gram of solution, 10% means 10 gram of B is present in 100 gram of solution. So therefore mass of water in A is 96 gram, mass of B in water in B is 90 gram. So we have this. This is second question. Next question says, the depression and freezing point of 10 power minus 2 molal aqueous formic acid solution is 0.024046. 1 molal urea aqueous solution of urea freezes at 1.86 degree centigrade, assuming molarity is equals to molality, what is the pH of solution? Now we have this. So this acid HCOOH being a weak acid, this partially undergoes dissociation to give you formate ion plus H plus ion. Now invoking the concept of equilibrium, at equilibrium the equilibrium concentration is C1 minus alpha. So look at this, 1 mole gives you 1 mole, so this is C alpha, this is C alpha, C is the initial concentration, alpha is the degree of dissociation. So initial concentration question says molarity is equals to molality, so C is given as 10 power minus 2. Now we have to find the values of alpha. Now to find the values of alpha, we have this given condition. So now look at this, 1 molar urea solution freezes at from urea solution. So we have look at this, delta Tf is equals to KFm. So therefore Kf is equals to delta Tf by m. Delta Tf is 1.86 divided by 1. So then we have this Kf from urea solution. Now for this solution of formic acid, delta Tf will be equals to I times Kf into m. So therefore I is equals to delta Tf divided by Kf into molality. So therefore I equals to delta Tf is 0.02046, Kf is 1.86, molality is 10 to the power minus 2. So this can be written as 1.86 into 10 power minus 2 can be written as 186 into 10 power minus 4. So this comes out to be 204.6 divided by 186. So this is I value. So I is 204.6. So if you look at it, this is slightly greater than 1 but less than 2. So 1 point something. Now we have to find the values of alpha. So alpha, now we have relation between alpha and degree of dissociation. So alpha is equals to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. So we have this value of I, 204.6 divided by 186 minus 1 divided by N. Look at this, 1 molecule of acid gives you 2 moles of ion. So N equals to 2 here. Number of moles of ions produced by one molecule. So we have 2 minus 1. So this is 204.6 minus 186 divided by 186. So this comes out to be 0.6. So look at this, we have this, divided by 186. So this is 0.1. Now alpha, degree of dissociation is 0.1. Now once we have this alpha, we can easily find out this H plus ion concentration. So therefore look at this, H plus ion concentration is C times alpha. C is 10 to the power minus 2, alpha is 10 power minus 1, so this is 10 power minus 3. So therefore pH, which is negative logarithm of H plus ion, so this is negative logarithm of 10 to the power minus 3 is equals to 3. So pH of the solution is 3. So now look at this question involves concept of equilibrium. So what is the equilibrium concentration of H plus ions? So to find this equilibrium concentration of H plus ion, we need to have the values of alpha. To find this value of alpha, we have to use this colligative property. From this colligative property, we find the values of I. And finally, we use the relationship between I and the degree of dissociation to find the values of the pH of this aqueous solution of formic acid. Next question says, the osmotic pressures of 0.01 molar aqueous solutions of Ki and sucrose are 0.43 and 0.24 atm respectively. What is the Van Noort factor I for Ki? So now osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure of Ki is equals to I times CrT. Similarly, osmotic pressure of sucrose is equals to I times CrT of sucrose. So therefore, now we divide this equation, osmotic pressure of Ki by osmotic pressure of sucrose. So we get this pi of Ki divided by pi of sucrose is equals to I times CrT divided by of Ki I times CrT of sucrose solution. Now we have to find the I of Ki. This is CrT. Temperature remaining constant, R is a gas constant. Concentration is also same, 0.01 molar. So I of sucrose being a non-dissociating or associating electrolyte. So I for sucrose is 1. So this is CrT. So this cancels out. So therefore, I of Ki is equals to partial pressure of Ki divided by osmotic pressure of sucrose. So this is 0.432. divided by 0.24. So this is the Van Noort factor I for Ki. So this is 43.2 divided by 24. So now okay, this is slightly less than 2, so approximately 1.89 approximately. So this is the value of Van Noort factor for I for Ki solution. Next question says, calculate the percentage dissociation of an electrolyte XY2. Normal molar mass of the solute is 164 in water if the observed molecular mass obtained by measuring elevation and boiling point is 65.6. Now, question says, molecular mass normal, that is theoretical, is 164. Molecular mass observed, that is experimental, is 65.6. Now we have to find the values of alpha. Now look at this, we have a dissociation. So for this dissociation, we have to find the values of I. Now once we find the values of I, we can easily relate this I with alpha. Now this Van Noort factor I is equals to colligative property experimental divided by colligative property theoretical, and all colligative property is inversely related to molecular mass of solute. So this can be written as molecular mass normal divided by molecular mass observed. because colligative property is inversely related to the molecular mass. So therefore, we have given molecular mass, normal, that is theoretical and experimental condition. So normal is 164, observed is 65.6. So we have this I, that is the Van Hoff factor I, that is how many moles of iron is produced in the solution. So now look at this. So this is, we have I. Once we have this I, we can define that is alpha. So now we have alpha. Alpha is equals to I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. Now we have to find the values of N. So assuming if this undergoes dissolution x, y, 2. So x, y, 2 dissociates to give you x 2 plus plus 2, y minus. So 2 plus 1, so N equals to 3. So I is 164 divided by 65.6 minus 1 divided by 2 minus 1. So this comes out to be 164 minus 65.6 divided by 65.6. So this is 98.4 divided by 65.6. So this is the degree of dissociation. Now to find the percentage, we have to multiply this by 100. So this is the percentage dissociation of this electrolyte. So this is how we define. So why I am giving this question? Because we can define this I, Van Hoff factor, if observed and theoretical molecular mass is given to you. So I is equals to theoretical molecular mass divided by observed molecular mass. Why this ratio? Because I is equals to experimental colligative property divided by theoretical colligative property, and the colligative property is inversely related to the molecular mass of solute. So this is how we define alpha from I and I from molecular mass of solute. Next question says, a 10 to power minus 2 molal acetic acid solution produces a delta TF, or means depression and freezing point, of 0.0194 degree centigrade. The degree of dissociation of the acid is, if Kf is given as 1.86. Now concentration given, Kf given, delta TF given, so what we can find out is I. Once we define this I, we can easily define degree of dissociation. So now look at this. We have delta TF is equal to I times Kf into M. So therefore I is equals to delta TF divided by Kf into M. So therefore I equals to delta TF is 0.0194. Kf is 1.86, molality is 10 to the power minus 2, so this comes out to be 194 divided by 186. So this is again 1 point something. So once we have this I, we can easily define alpha. So alpha is I minus 1 divided by N minus 1. Now we have to find the values of N. So question says acetic acid, look at this, CH3COOH gives you CH3COO minus plus H plus N. So now look at this. 1 mole of this acid gives you how many moles of iron? 2. So therefore N equals to 2 here. So therefore alpha is 194 by 186 minus 1 divided by 2 minus 1. So this is 194 minus 186 divided by 186. So this is 8 divided by 186. So 8 divided by 186. This is the degree of dissociation. So this is coming around 0.04. Approximately this is coming 0.04. So this is how we define alpha. So next question says, when some sodium chloride was dissolved in water, the depression and freezing point produced was numerically equals to twice of Kf, that is molar depression and freezing point constant. Then the relative lowering of vapor pressure of the solution is nearly. So first, NaCl. So NaCl is an electrolyte. So this will undergo dissociation. So now first look at this. We have this delta Tf. Delta Tf is equal to I times Kf m. So therefore look at this. Question again says delta Tf is twice of Kf. So therefore delta Tf is twice of Kf, which is equals to I times m into Kf. So therefore Kf, Kf will cancel, so I times m is equals to 2. So this is for NaCl solution. Now question says, if this is the case, then what is the relative lowering of vapor pressure? Now we have to define this relative lowering of vapor pressure. Now we have a relationship, relative lowering of vapor pressure is equals to I times m into molecular mass of solvent divided by 1000. So this equation gives you the relation between relative lowering of vapor pressure and the molality. Now I into m is equals to 2, so we replace here 2 into molecular mass of solvent. So this is aqueous solution, so we have 18 divided by 1000. So this is 36 divided by 1000. So that is 0.036. So the relative lowering of vapor pressure produces 0.036. So now look at this. First, from this depression and freezing point, we define the values of I into m. And from this molality, we relate this molality with relative lowering of vapor pressure. So this is a very important question, relative lowering of vapor pressure and the molality of solution. So relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to I times molality into molecular mass of solvent divided by 1000. So I into m is equal to 2 from this NaCl solution. So we have this. So this is the relative lowering of vapor pressure produced. Next question says, a 5% weight by volume solution of cane sugar whose molecular mass is 342 is isotonic with 4% weight by volume of substance X. Then what is the molar mass of X? So the first of all, question says isotonic. So isotonic means the one having same osmotic pressure. So therefore look at this. For isotonic solution, osmotic pressure of cane sugar will be equal to osmotic pressure of unknown compound X. Now since nothing is mentioned about this temperature, so means both these solutions are maintained at the same temperature. So if the same temperature is equal to concentration of cane sugar must be equal to concentration of X, because we have osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure is CRT. So for both the solution, R is a constant, temperature remains same. So pi 1 equals to pi 2. So the concentration is number of moles divided by volume. So number of moles, because this is 5% weight by volume. So total volume is 100 ml. So this is number of moles divided by volume. So number of moles is by volume of C is equals to number of moles divided by volume of X. So therefore number of moles is mass divided by molar mass. So mass of cane sugar is 5, so 5 divided by 342 into volume is 100 ml. So 100 ml means 0.1 liter. So this equals to mass of this substance X is 4%. So 4 gram divided by molar mass into volume is 0.1. So look at this. This and this will cancel out. So therefore, molar mass of X is equals to 4 into 342 divided by 5. So this equals to 4 into 5, 6 is 30. So this comes out to be 273.6. So this is the molecular mass of unknown substance X. So again, look at this here. Condition of isotonic. Isotonic means two different solutions having same osmotic pressure. Osmotic pressure is CRT. If the temperatures are same, then concentration of 1 is equal to concentration of 2. Now we define this concentration after number of moles by volume. Now question says 5% weight by volume. So 5 gram is present in 100 ml. So the volume is 100 ml. Same 4 gram of substance X is present in 100 ml. So again volume remaining same. So number of moles of C is equal to number of moles of X. So number of moles is mass divided by molar mass. From this we define the molar mass. So next question says, insulin is dissolved in a suitable solvent whose osmotic pressure at various concentration measured in terms of gram per centimeter cube at 20 degree centigrade. The slope of the osmotic pressure versus concentration is given. So what is the molar mass of insulin? So now question is osmotic pressure. So we have osmotic pressure is equals to N by V R T. N is number of moles divided by volume. So this can be written as mass divided by volume into R T by M. So number of moles is mass divided by molar mass. Now this, if you look at this, unit of concentration is gram per centimeter cube. So mass divided by volume. So this mass divided by volume is defined as concentration. So this is concentration C R T by M. So question says the slope of the pi against concentration C. So if you look at this, make this graph. This is osmotic pressure, this is concentration. So this is gram per centimeter cube. So this is equation of straight line passing through origin, where the slope is equals to RT by M. So question says pi versus concentration slope is 4.65 into 10 power minus 3. So therefore look at this. Therefore slope is equals to RT by M. So therefore M molar mass is equals to RT by slope. So R is 0.082. Temperature is 20 degree, so 20 plus 273, 293 divided by slope. Slope is 4.65. So we can say 465 into 10 to the power minus 5. So we can write down as 293 into 82 into 10 to the power 2 divided by 465. So this is the molecular mass of the protein. That is insulin. So this is how we use different formulas of Golgi properties. So these are some of the typical examples that I want to discuss with you regarding Golgi properties, how different formulas of colligative properties are used for both electrolytes and non-electrolytes. For electrolytes, how we define this I from the colligative properties and how this I is related to the degree of dissociation or degree of association, or how this I can be related to the molecular mass of the solute and various interconversions. So hopefully you can do this objective questions. Thank you all.